This is Erin. She hasn't been with us for a while. At least on video. She's here, but she's not on video. I'm Mark. We're going to show you the deadlift. This is our Wednesday part A, which is our strength portion. We do a deadlift, a core exercise, and then rest. So there's three people in our little pod, and we just go around that way. So deadlift, core, rest. We're going to spend most of our time on the deadlift. So you can take a sumo stance, which is wide, or you can take a conventional stance. We'll show you in the sumo. We'll show the majority of it. Sumo style, that's Erin's preferred style. I don't have a preferred style, whatever you think you're stronger and more comfortable with, that's fine with me. I would say you should mix it up once in a while, but here we go. So first, you want to step right up to the bar. We always tell people, touch your shins to the bar, only because we know they may not. They might get an inch away, which is right where we want you. But when you go down, your shins may come forward the slightest bit. Depending on your limb length, some people are straight up and down with their shins, some people aren't. So, looks like this. After you take your mixed grip, generally, your knee joint is here. Your hip joint should be between your shoulder and your knee. So if I draw a line straight back, Erin's hip are somewhere between there, not too low. This is now a quad dominant exercise. Now her knees are way out in front. She's gonna have a very hard time lifting this bar. You can stand up. So if you force yourself to get close, you're forced to sit back with it and shins not coming forward. So I would say for Erin, maybe her hips should be up a tiny bit more, right? Because that moves her shins back out of the way and that pushes her sternum over the center of the bar, which it should be. So from here, she's going to take a breath and pull up on the bar. Not pull the bar up, just get force to the bar. As she continues to pull up, she's gonna drive her heels, boom. See that hip drive at the top, okay? So, stand up again. There's three steps here, at least. After you grab the bar, it's a big breath, hold tight. You're gonna pull up on the bar. This bar is only 105 pounds. She's gonna pull up with 104 pounds of force. So still, the bar is heavier than her pull, so it's not going anywhere. Then, continue to pull up. Then she's gonna think, drive her heels down and away. Magically, the bar comes up. Don't think to lift the bar. Think, do those three steps first in that order, not at the same time, okay? Can you show it real quick? Here's what it looks like going at the same time, okay? It's gonna be a little off. It was actually pretty good. But a little off would mean she's in a good setup even, but she just does that. Butt will come up a little bit first. We don't want your butt to come up. That is dangerous for your back. Pulling up and driving down are opposing forces, which are meeting right at your glutes. The force that lifts this weight, right? So your upper back just gets stiff and tight, and then the force from your legs goes up right to your glutes, and then bam, the weight goes right. So let's do it again, let's do two in a row, okay? Sternum over the bar, hips a little bit high, big breath, pull, heels, hip drive, right there. Her core is tight, her butt is squeezed tight, so if she holds this bar, the forces are just passing right through. If she relaxed, boom, like that, the forces will be going right out her lower back. Okay, one more time, breath, hip drive, just like so. Okay. Conventionally, is a close stance. Can you come around here, Kevin? Mm-hmm. Conventional is just a close stance. It's very similar. Some people prefer it, but again, it's going to look the same. Okay. Still the hip drive, core, butt tight, just like so. Okay. All right. So we generally do four sets of that, and also we vary the reps from week to week. We usually don't go more than 6, maybe 7 reps at the deadlift. Our heavy week, we go between 2 and 3 reps, if you're comfortable with that. Coupled with that, as I said, it's a core exercise. This one looks very easy. It's a push-up-ish position, just a little bit outside your hips with your feet and close hands, okay? So from here, you always want to make sure you don't fall through like that. See her shoulder blades now? Mm-hmm. I could grab them and there's wrinkles in her shirt, right? You want to push through. That's called a plus. Now she's stable through her shoulder, right? Then opposite stable through here. You're going to take a breath. good, or core tight, boom. What you didn't see here was movement, right? Okay, just like so. Now I'll do it wrong. Here's what you're gonna see. There, right there. This is now not a core exercise. If there's any movement down here, that means nothing's going on in here, right? If she raises one hand, now there's rotational forces going down this way. If nothing moves here, that means everything is tight and working here. Now it's a core exercise, because one hand or one leg causes rotation up or down your torso, right? And if visually there's no movement when you do that, just like that, that means everything is working, okay? Boom, okay? You can do, I don't know, 5 or 6 each side there, okay? While your partner does the deadlift. How do you feel?
Good.
Okay.
Done.
All right, so that's our part A. After that, you would rest. And then we'll move on to the workout. That will be later. But try the deadlift, sumo, and conventional. Try to load it as comfortably as you can, but try to load it up, okay?
Good.
This is Aaron. I'm Mark, signing off.